I'm Al Roberts, and this is a two-minute summary of my new article in Public Administration Review called Who Should We Count as Citizens? Citizenship is a core concept in our field. It's often used in recent empirical research, but there are two problems. First, the concept is rarely defined explicitly when it is used. And second, the implicit definition is usually very broad. Citizens are equated with residents, members of the public, members of the general population, or simply people or persons. This is problematic for two reasons. First, most scholars in the field of citizenship studies and most non-academics don't define citizenship this broadly, so there's a risk of misunderstanding when we use the concept differently. Secondly, there's good evidence that the legal status of citizenship, actually shapes attitudes and behavior, the attitudes and behavior of people toward government, and also of government officials toward people. So there's a risk of unreliable findings when we define the concept too broadly. There are four simple fixes to this difficulty. First, use the concept that's appropriate for the research project, which might mean not talking about citizens at all. Secondly, when the concept of citizen is used, define it explicitly. Thirdly, use a more mainstream definition of what citizen means. And finally, pay more attention to the ways in which the attitudes and behaviors of people and government officials might be shaped by legal status or other kinds of status within a jurisdiction. The article is now available on Public Administration Review.